guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Becky Arfette, and if this is your first time here, I am a senior undergrad at the University of Georgia studying dietetics. And if you haven't seen the previous two videos, me explaining what the cycle seeking method is and the hormonal menstrual cycle video, I'll go ahead and link it up here and down below so you can go ahead and watch those. But woohoo, we are finally in our follicular phase. We just got done with our menstrual little week, so now we have a whole bunch more energy. We are back to our normal crazy self, and let's get on to this video because we have a lot to talk about. We are feeling different, we are awake, we are energized, and we love the follicular phase. The first question I ask myself every single morning when I wake up is how I was feeling, and especially during this phase, my testosterone levels are more up. That means I can build muscle better, but I just decided to just listen to my body, ease into this week with a little bit of morning yoga. And to my right, I actually saw this cool climbing jungle gym, so it was an awesome way just to get up moving and start off this beautiful week. During these phases, I like to focus on three words when it comes to my food: fresh, vibrant, and energy. I like to focus on light foods that give me more energy during this phase. So this is lunch, especially during my follicular phase. I really eat my fresh fruits and vegetables. If you don't like the taste of the fresh fruits and vegetables, you can like blanch them in hot water real quick just to like make it more like a cooked feeling. But I focus on my fresh fruits and vegetables because they, I cannot stress, contain so much micro and macronutrients that your body really needs right now. So after you menstruate, your body needs to have all those natural vitamins and minerals, and especially iron, just because what you went through. Protein, especially like fattier proteins like ribs and chicken, especially the rotisserie chickens, are super great for your body. Like, I love to eat ribs, and I used to shy away from them, but the ribs are so good. And like, honestly, eating healthy and nutritious doesn't have to be eating a whole bunch of kale and salads all day. Like, look at this. How delicious is this? So just because it's the time of the month and it's all about the cardio and the HIIT workouts, sometimes that can be redundant and tedious, and sometimes you don't want to do burpees. So one of the people I love to do is the fitness marshal. Follow along his dancing workouts. Definitely a good type of cardio. Makes you feel good. You laugh out doing weird moves. So let me show you. You can see I don't really wear my Apple Watch anymore, just because I'm all about how the workout makes me feel versus how many calories I burn, because why should I let a little number on a stupid little watch determine how I feel? So I go out there, I work out, I feel great, endorphins are high, dopamine's high, serotonin's high, everything's high, and one of the funnest workouts ever. And that's why who needs a watch to tell you how you can feel? So I've been craving something sweet lately, and my mom actually made this pumpkin bread on top of it that is not whipped cream or Cool Whip, that is actually Greek plain yogurt. And what else adds the extra sweetness is all the natural sugars from the strawberries and the blackberries. And I use a little bit of this golden coconut sugar. It's low glycemic index, and it's 15 calories per teaspoon, but we don't count calories over here. And this is especially good for helping out with my gut health, and actually week two of refining my whole hormone cycle. During this time, my blood sugar is back to normal, but I don't want to really spike it, because when you spike your blood sugar, insulin happens, and then that stores more fat, and then when you store more fat, Our adipose tissues are active endocrine glands, and that is where you turn your estrogen into estradiol, and then that turns into testosterone, which is androgens, and that makes you break out, have PMS, tender breasts, all the symptoms of your cycle. That's why I take to coconut sugar, but I'll go ahead, link the references down below. And I made this with almond flour, and that is how you can have something that is high in fiber, awesome macros and micronutrients from the berries and the pumpkins, and that is how you can eat nutritiously without, you know, disturbing your body. So, just because I'm a dietetic student and I work out all the time and I eat extra healthy doesn't mean you can enjoy life. I'm all about memories over macros. And so right now I'm at the Avalon. If you're in this area and take this, I got the Dibola pizza. So this is what it looks like. Thin crust, super good. First bite is the best bite. Let's sink it. Straight 10 out of 10. And this is for all the boys out there.
Oh yeah,
not for you, but subscribe though. No pizzas are left behind when you're in my family or with me. On that note, who's ready for round two? Just a little skin update. I have a few little blemishes here and there, but definitely a lot better than my skin was before. I think that's due to me eating the cheese on the pizza and drinking kefir. I am lactose intolerant, so that is definitely showing on my face. And so now I know what I can and what I can't have. It's pretty cool how the skin is like the larger organ on your body and it can tell you so much. So this is an update on my skin, but later on I'll tell you what I do for my skincare routine. Okay, so it's pretty cool that your skin can actually tell you what you're allergic to or not, because when I ate the pizza, I developed a lot of like acne out of nowhere, and so my skin was telling me that I am actually allergic to dairy. And so I did a little bit more research, and it says if I experience ovulation pain, period pain, acne, bloating, gas, upset stomach, sinus congestions, repeated cold and flus. So I've actually experienced all of that, and I kind of knew I was allergic to dairy, but not that allergic. And thanks to my skin, it was literally telling me all along. And so how can I do that? So reducing / removing conventional and non-organic dairy. That's what I'm going to do for 28 days. I'm going to see if that actually really does help. See if I don't have any more period pain, ovulation pain, or upset stomach, or bloating. And let me see how it is during cold and flu seasons. So what happens is dairy comes from factory farms that are fed grain, corn, soy, which makes the cows inflamed because they're not used to eating that. And so hormones are in the milk and they're injected, and it affects us, affects our female hormones. And so what you can probably go, or maybe if you can't cut out dairy, I would definitely suggest full fat, organic, free from hormones, pesticides, fermented type of milk like kefir if you can actually drink it. I know I can't drink it. So you're asking, what's part in the dairy that is making us allergic? So it's not the fat. Actually, full fat dairy helps support ovulation, fertilities. So it's not the lactose, because lactose is a sugar in dairy and it can be tricky to digest. So it might be the hormones, but which is the actual thing is, why does it cause pain? So it's probably problem with the cow's dairy. It's called a protein called A1 casein, which is a form of inflammatory opiate. Basically, it makes it so that you have inflammatories in your bodies, and that makes it so that you hurt. So it plays a really big role. So I'm going to go ahead, and I'm not restricting myself with dairy, but I'm just going to go ahead and see what I'm allergic to and see if it actually helps me. Around this time, it's essential for you to get in fresh fruits and veggies, but I like to eat sweet potatoes, especially if I'm craving something sweet. Sweet potatoes contain beta carotene, which is like a vitamin A form. Super good. This actually curbs my sweet tooth, put a little bit of hot sauce on it, and it is bomb, dog. Just freshly got out the shower. I have a couple of blemishes, but you definitely know that's from the pizza that I ate a couple days before. I am lactose intolerant, and I finally proved it. But my same skin routine is like how I do it during the menstrual cycle, but during this time, my skin, or our skin, is very more like tough or more elastic. And so all I do is just wash my face with the normal Trader Joe's soap in the shower. Then I do this exfoliant from Trader Joe's. I love that store, but not sponsored. Hopefully sponsor me. But anyway, I do this like berry acai facial scrub about like 3 times a week in order just to get the impurities like out of my skin. I do the nourishing oil. I skip the vitamin C oil just because I don't want to like acids like mixing on my skin. I just put my lotion on. I put on a little bit of this prebiotic deodorant. I don't use deodorant that has aluminum in it because there are researches that says it links to cause like breast cancer. So we just use the Natural Toms deodorant with probiotics in it. And we do a little bit of like lip gloss, a Biotins for the eyelashes, and call it a day. But on that note, I am going to end this vlog. Thank you so much for coming on this journey with me. We have 2 more videos left, the ovulatory phase and the luteal phase. I cannot wait to show you guys those videos. But if you haven't seen those other 2 videos, I'll go ahead and link them down below before this. And please subscribe to me. This honestly helps me out. Leave me a comment. Leave me what you've learned about or what you want to know about or how this is even a breakthrough experience. But anyway, I will see you on the next video. Stay positive. Don't forget to eat your rainbow. And I will see you on the next video. Bye, guys.